Hello everyone and welcome back to part 3 of Darrel's special series on drawing with greater accuracy. In today's presentation, Darrel connects the dots and we get to see the divider portion of the straight edge and divider method. So stay tuned, we've got a lot of learning coming up. All right, everybody, we're back with part 3 of our series on drawing with greater accuracy. That's part 3 of 3, our final video. And we're going to jump right in here. Today, Darrel is going to, well, we're going to kind of wrap this drawing up. We're going to plot a couple more points, kind of connect all the dots and see what this outline actually looks like. And then Darrel's going to introduce the divider portion of the straight edge and divider method. So I'll stop talking and let's jump right to it, Darrel.
Hey, glad you could join us for this third of the three-part series. We're talking about the layout. This straight edge and divider is just a fabulous opportunity for not only for you to have an accurate layout, but also continue to teach you, to help you start seeing things that I think a lot of people often miss. If you can learn how to see angles and curves and get the proper structure and the proportion, it just makes you feel so much better about the rest of your drawing. As you see it start out well with a good foundation, then you have an opportunity to, just kind of have a little more comfort and be able to interpret your drawing and apply the techniques that I like to share with you. Over the past two, we started out with some of the things that I think were important to have good results from this method. And let me just go over a few of those things with you real quick. I've gone through and I have put a little dot everywhere I want to find something. I could put a dot anywhere I want. I could put a dot clear out here and I'll be able to find it accurately because I'm going to be able to come at it from two different points. And that's basically what we'll do when we get off of either one of these bearing lines. We'll be able to go ahead and find any feature we want. We can go ahead and put dots all the way along here and we can find them so that you can go ahead and copy this, contour and know where the bend in the jaw or the cheek is, you know, so that you can accurately capture her character. Now you can do as little as you want. And that's another nice thing about this because the grid has so many lines. And I think many of you have probably had the problem of being able to remove them. So I'm using a 2B pencil. I don't want to go too dark. I certainly don't want to press too hard. And I want to try to keep from pushing my point into the paper as I go on a line when I'm using a straight edge or something, because that tends to just bury that graphite into the paper a little bit more. And we want to be able to erase all those lines because they're such a contrast with the wonderful curves and flow of a person's face or whatever we happen to be drawing. So what I want to do now is I'm going to go ahead and just, let's put that dot out here and just to see if we can duplicate that on our paper. Let's see what we can do about finding this dot. Maybe I should have gone, I'm out too far. So I'm going to come on the inside. This is one more thing I just want to remind you about. If you have a scrap piece of art paper, most of us do. We have something that didn't turn out, but this is thick, just like the 300 series Strathmore Bristol. It's the same thing I'm drawing on, and so I can take some spray mount and I can spray the back of my print that I printed off my printer, and I can go ahead and then trim it, make sure it's very square. You use a right angled triangle, something like this will help you be able to make sure that you have the thing square. And then if you have a guillotine cutter or something like that, you want to make sure that you're getting them at right angles and not having a parallelogram. But anyway, the thickness of this paper is wonderful because then when I attach my print onto it, it raises this up higher than the surface of the paper because I have the printer paper on it as well. So that's why when I come along here, I can now take this pivot point. I can come out to that dot we made out here. I'm still going to the same pivot point here. And I'm going to now slide this paper along. Oh, and I need longer. I forgot about that. It's nice to have a 2-foot ruler or a straight edge because sometimes it's really nice to be able to reach out there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to scoot this along, making sure this stays parallel with the edge of my print, and I'm going to match it up until it comes to that pivot bearing point again. So now I know my line's out here somewhere, so I'll put a little longer line out here. And now I'm going to come from the other side. I'm going to go ahead and pivot from this side as well, because all I need to do is intersect that line, know exactly where it should be intersected, and I'll have that thing pinpointed in just the right place. So I'm going to come out here like this. And then I'll show you why I'm showing you this. I've got to come out here to this new pivot point. These are our anchors. These are the things that are going to help us keep this thing absolutely accurate, and making sure this is still exactly parallel, the print and the paper. So here we are. Now I know that where this crossed is that dot. And let's go ahead and take a look at that a little closer, see if we can, oh, here we are with that dot. Now naturally we don't want these around here, but I have the dot. I can pinpoint anything I want on that paper. And so that's exactly how I did each one of these features. I came in and I said, you know what, I want to find this. I went to my little one here and I put my dot on there, and naturally all I have to do is line up these features, any one of those dots that I've decided that's where I want to go ahead and find the distance or the thickness or the whatever it happens to be. And I'm going to come over here and I'm going to be able to find out where that is from one angle, and then I want to be able to intersect it. Lining it up with this pivot point, I got the pivot point on my paper, and now I have a chance to go ahead and make a little longer line, because I don't know how short it's going to be or how long it's going to be, and then I can come back from a different place. Maybe I can come back in this case from the middle one, because angles are always true. It's a wonderful thing if I can go ahead and make sure that I have things lined up right, and I have this from even that center bearing point over to this dot that I've made. Hard to see in this reflection. But then this is going to tell me where it's going to intersect that line. And so it's right there. So here's my line. Now I have a chance to come in, and if I want to, and I don't have enough dots on there, but I'm just showing you that I can come in and now know that this line is part of that cheek. And if I have this in the same orientation, then I have a chance to know where the turn is. Okay. And you can start seeing this develop. We can use now our divider. If we start getting enough things on here, then I'm going to say, okay, well, maybe I have enough on here that I can start using this effectively. And what the divider is it's a comparative measuring tool. And one of the great things about this is that you can use a recipe. You can go to what you want to find. I'm going to try and find the outer part of her hair here. And I'm going to go to what I want to find, go to an anchor point, go to something substantial that I really can identify. Could be the corner of an eye, could be this, but this is a good start here. And so then I'm going to find an equivalent. Let's find something that's the same. Oh, look at that. My. It doesn't always work out that way, but this goes from that bearing pivot point up to the middle. And so now I'm going to go to my drawing. This is the recipe. You go to what you want to find, you go and find an equivalent, you go to that equivalent. Now it's going to be a little different measurement. It's coincidentally just about the same, but we're going to go ahead and make sure I adjust this so that it's exactly the same as the equivalent, and then I'm going to go back up to what I wanted to find in the first place. And here we are. If it's important to know the angle, because we have a curve here, and it obviously would be a different distance from the center as we go around, well, I probably would want to make sure that I have this at the same angle. I may want to mark it and then use my straight edge. And I can do that as well, just so I know that I'm going in the same place the same angle. So I can keep this thing parallel. This is too big. Always a challenge, again, trying to show this on camera. But I can go ahead and get the general direction. Keeping it parallel, that's hard with the big one. But here's my line, and so here's going to be the opportunity for me now to take that line and come out here. So here's my line. Hair is a little more forgiving, so it gives me a chance to just get something that's a little softer edge. I don't have to worry quite so much about copying it exactly, and then I can go ahead and continue on with my drawing of the head. And I know where the top is because I documented where this is, and I know that this is gonna come up a little bit. I can document any part of that curve. That's what I want to try and let you know. I'm not going to take the time to do it all now, but this is a great way of being able to find exactly what you want to document so that you can draw with great proportion. We have the ear down here, so we want to be able to keep this in the same orientation. I could find out how far over the ear is, and then with my divider, I could find out how, you know, it is from the side of the face out to the outside of the ear. And also, I want to document it so I know exactly what I was looking at. So here's the hair coming down, here's that ear. I've documented the other one over here. And I could find that again with coming from two different directions. Oh, here we have this off. Here's the other ear. And I can find that easily by coming from two different directions. Even though there's hair in front of it and I don't want to make too much out of the ear, it's still important for me to know where that is because it keeps developing, you know, this proportion and starts getting me off on the right track. So here's this curve. I think I can probably pay attention to where it turns, where's the apex of the curve here, and duplicate that pretty nice. But then sometimes it's easy to not realize how much of a curve there is. Sometimes it may look curved and it isn't actually a curve. So I can take it maybe from two points. I'm going to take it from where the ear joins to where the finger, you know, goes in front of there. And I'm going to put that there so that I can now see how much of a curve it is. So when I'm drawing this, I can try and duplicate that. I could put a straight edge, you know, here as well. And do the comparison. The visual comparisons are great. The comparative measurements that you can make with this, again, with the opportunity you have to find an equivalent, and you can come from the corner of the mouth to the edge of the face and find the equivalent. Coincidentally, it's just about the eye there. And so now we have an opportunity, see, to find out where the edge of the face. I was able to go ahead and hit that pretty close, but the divider is not a compass. If you go into the store, I'm surprised at how many people in art stores don't even know when you ask for a divider, they'll give you a compass. Make sure that you have one that you just spread with your hands. Don't have the one with the adjustment wheel in there. That's for making circles very precisely, and it is not a divider. They usually don't spread far enough. Sometimes we may want to go way out there when we have a measurement way outside, maybe to a part of the clothing or something from the tip of a nose or an eye or something, and we need that extra spread. But it's a comparative measurement tool. Wonderful. And it's a great way to keep yourself on track so that you can find those little things that might have gotten off a little bit. Maybe your straight edge slipped just a little bit. And so you have a chance then to continually adjust your proportion. Now, the next thing you want to do is you want to start being able to take off these things. Once you don't need those anymore, you want to get those off. So you never want to go ahead and draw them on there with too much pressure, too dark, because then they're going to be, showing through some of your fine tones and values on the face that you're creating or whatever the subject might be. But anyway, there's so much to tell you about, and I get a little bit excited, and it's easy not to remember one thing or another that can help you. But the good thing about this is I have this DVD that is available right now. If you go down to the bottom of your video, you'll see an opportunity to take an opportunity to get that. And if you like it, share it with your friends. Appreciate that. But this will help you have a lot more information in there. You'll have a chance to, again, replay it, go back and review it. You'll have it all the time instead of hoping that you saw the video and absorbed everything there was to absorb. So I hope that this little series, you know, helps you. I think it's an exciting opportunity, not only, again, to you know, come up with something very accurate, but to continue training the way you view your subject in your drawing. When you're drawing from life, you want to be able to see angles and curves and have those little opportunities to realize, well, I think it turns about there. So when you see that on your subject, you see that it lines right up, you know, with the corner of a mouth. You always have something you can compare. And when we have these vertical and horizontal lines like this, we have an opportunity to have that we can visualize on a subject that even may be at a distance. Maybe we don't have a photo reference or something, but at least it helps you start looking at those things. You know, notice the little personality to a subject. And you know, it could be a dog's head. You know how they like to just kind of cock their head to one side, you know, when they're listening to you. And you want to be able to capture those things and then have everything continue to build in relationship to those angles, which are so important, and not have something, you know, become out of perspective or out of proportion. But the good thing about this method is you have a chance to correct anytime you want to. If you go through the initial five free lessons, it'll give you a good insight of how to create your drawing so that you can always make these alterations and adjustments if you just happen to, you know, look at it differently later, or maybe you miss something. And appreciate it. If you, you know, if you viewed these, I hope you enjoyed it and it was useful. And we also have that DVD. So see you next time. We always appreciate your feedback. So don't forget to let us know how this may have helped you and share it with your friends. So we'll see you next time.
On behalf of Darrel, myself, and the entire Five Pencil Method team, we'd like to say a big thank you for watching this series on drawing with greater accuracy. And as Darrel stated in the video, we do have a DVD series that is devoted specifically to this straight edge and divider method. And as a way of saying thank you for joining us for this series, we want to offer it to you at a special discount. It's five classes where Darrel takes it step by step, breaks it down to its core, and shows you the tiny details that are going to make all the difference as you lay out your drawings. And because this method is so near and dear to Darrel, and he loves to share it with as many aspiring artists as possible, we want to make it as accessible as possible. So, starting right now and lasting for a short time, we're going to offer this DVD series to you of five classes for 50% off. Plus, we'll be throwing in a free gift just as an added bonus. So, if you're interested in learning more about this series and drawing with greater accuracy, taking your drawing to the next level, we invite you to click on the link on this page. You can either click right on the video or you can click below. But again, thank you so much for joining us, and we hope to hear from you soon. Take care.